I really feel like talking about some music, but I can't depend on albums I find really interesting to be released frequently, and I want to share some older stuff. So I guess I'll try something new with this video.
Hey, you're gonna mess up my entire video format.
Whatever, you can't do anything to me from that dimension. Anyway, here goes. So, like the title of the video says, I'm going to share some music I've been listening to lately, no matter if it's old or new. It feels nice to do this, as I can mention stuff I find really neat but don't really want to make a full review of. First off, I have a new release from Violent Magic Orchestra, Principle of Lightspeed Invariance. Violent Magic Orchestra is a side project of an already very experimental Japanese heavy music band, Vampilia, that goes even heavier, combining elements of techno, black metal and harsh noise music. Their full-length album, Catastrophic Anonymous, very quickly became one of my favorite things ever, as it mastered one of the most intense walls of noise I've heard that is still oddly beautiful. Naturally, I was very excited about anything new from this project. Principle of Lightspeed Invariance is way shorter release with only 3 songs in it, making the whole thing around 11 minutes long. And to be honest, I did not like it as much on first listen, as it was a bit softer than the previous album. It had more moments that get fairly close to being ambient, but the EP quickly grew on me to the point where I'd listen to it every day. Highly recommend this one to fans of heavier industrial music. Then there's a new album by Aristider Lipsins that I won't even try to pronounce the title of. I find Icelandic to be very beautiful, but this looks intimidating. I discovered this because it was released by the wonderful Van Records label. I like pretty much everything they have, but came a bit as a surprise to me. Thing is, at this point I hate atmospheric black metal. I dislike some of the common practices in the genre when it comes to the sound. And whatever band I try giving a shot sounds exactly the same as hundreds of others. Aristider Lipsins, though, manages to sound very unique and interesting in the genre, getting past my prejudice without breaking a sweat. In a way, it reminds me a tiny bit of Rotten Christ, but except of Greek, they use very specific Norse sound. The heavier songs sound great, but there are also a lot of more peaceful, chant-like tracks that create a very magical feel. This brought me back some hope in atmospheric black metal, you know? Executor's Mask, Despair Anthems. This is the band's debut full-length album published by Profound Lore Records, another metal-focused label I really like that's recently been pushing out some more experimental stuff. Must say, I love this album. There's still some places to improve, but the core sound is exactly my thing. It doesn't sound too heavy, so I can still fairly comfortably play it around non-metalhead friends, but it has plenty of sludgy weight to it. The melodies are fairly simple and catchy, lyrics easy to understand. I must say I like the fairly unusual mixing. The somewhat deadpan vocals that sound pretty neat in my opinion are fairly low in the mix compared to everything else, making the actual music take the forefront. I really appreciate this kind of thing. So far, Despair Anthems is one of my favorite albums of the year. And now we have a couple of oldies. The Crazy World of Arthur Brown. This guy can easily be considered a pioneer of his genre who had a massive influence on rock and metal music. I decided to look into his 1968 debut album and enjoyed it a lot. I think this psychedelic rock opera thing aged incredibly well. It includes the chart-topping song Fire that has been sampled by all sorts of artists more times than I can count.
I am the god of hellfire!
It's a very theatrical album telling a one big story throughout it. I'd say this is a must listen to everyone as it's essentially a piece of music history now. But especially for those that are interested in the origins of psych, prog, and punk rock. Number 13, Salt. This album might not be objectively very good, but I've been listening to it on and off for a while. Salt is the first full-length album by this Icelandic metal band and was released back in 1994. I have yet to listen to their newer stuff to find out if it gets any more serious, but Salt sounds pretty corny and even generic at parts, but it has something very charming about it. I guess I have a similar relationship with this band as I do with DJ Swamp. I like it both ironically and unironically.
I've got a cat called sickness.
And if Sold by 13 does sound pretty cheap, some of the tunes do an amazing job at getting stuck in my head. I don't even know if I can recommend this album, to be honest, but it's been in rotation for me. Maybe it could be your thing as well. And I guess this is enough for one time. I don't want this video to get too long. I have no clue if this new format even works or not. I doubt I'll be able to do one of these every month, but there is a possibility. I just really enjoy discussing music. So if you've been listening to anything interesting lately, do let me know in the comments. I'm always up for hearing something new. Thanks for sticking around, and see you next time.